So we are introducing a new format for Bible studies, adult studies on Sunday this summer. We are still going to do our discussion guides on the website. They are posted on the website every Sunday, and all of the ones we've done for the past bigger story season, so all since January 1st, are on the website, along with kind of evergreen questions, how to read scripture, who, what, where, when, what observations to look at first. All of that is posted on the website and will continue to be. And then we're also going to introduce videos like this one today, probably not with a background like this in previous posts or in future posts, but we are going to talk specifically about one point of scripture or one thing that comes to mind. And we just want to encourage you to watch these videos and use these however you see fit, whenever you see fit, maybe after the sermon on Sunday or before to prepare for it. Share it with others, maybe continue the conversation at home. That's kind of the idea here, just giving you additional opportunities to be in the Word and to be talking about the Word. And this coming Sunday in June, the first week of June, we are going to talk about the Holy Trinity and the authority of Jesus, who is the wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace, and how he has all authority in heaven and on earth given to him by the Father, who saves us, who teaches us, who leads us, who sends us out to make disciples in his name, in the name of the Father and in the Son and in the Spirit, and what that means, and how great is that responsibility and privilege, and how we have hope and encouragement in that. But for this video, I actually want to zoom back and look a little bit more at Peter's sermon in Acts chapter 2. So right after Pentecost, which is what we talked about on Sunday, this last Sunday, we are introduced to Peter's response. And this is really answering the question, what just happened? What are we hearing? What are we experiencing? What explains all of this? And in verse 22, he starts, "Men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with mighty works and wonders and signs that God did through him in your midst. As you yourselves know, this Jesus, delivered up according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God, you crucified and killed by the hands of lawless men. God raised him up, loosening the pangs of death, because it was not possible for him to be held by it." So when the question came up, what just happened? What did we just experience? What did we just hear and overhear and see? His focus is to draw everything back to Jesus. His starting point is Jesus. Our starting point should always be Jesus. He uses historic facts. He uses what people knew about Jesus. He highlighted the power and the plan of God and how everything pointed back to Jesus. He then continues on, pulling from three different Old Testament sources in this speech, in this sermon, inspired by the Spirit. And he points to how everything is fulfilled in Jesus, how Jesus fulfills everything. He uses scripture to understand kind of an unexplainable situation. This is the lens of scripture, the lens through which he views the world is scripture, is the truth of scripture. And in this world in which pride and sin are just so vocally celebrated and called virtue, we need to ensure that we have the same kind of lens. We have the lens of scripture. We take everything to scripture. We trust scripture, its truth, and it's focused first and foremost on Jesus. When we encounter a strange situation, we go first to scripture. What does scripture have to say about it? We don't read scripture looking for self. We read scripture looking for Savior, looking for Jesus. Where is Jesus in these passages? We learn about him, and by learning about him, we learn about ourselves. It's getting windy, but he continues on in verse 36. "Let all the house of Israel know therefore for certain that God has made him both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the rest of the apostles, 'Brothers, what shall we do?' And Peter said to them, 'Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is for you and for your children and all who are far off, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to himself. For with many other words he bore witness and continued to exalt them, saying, save yourself from this crooked or perverse generation. So those who received his word were baptized, and they were added to that day about 3,000 souls. People live by what they believe. Our lives reflect our theology, who or what we worship. How can the way we read scripture even reflect Jesus, point to Jesus? We reflect and give reverence to God who calls us, who orchestrated this plan of redemption purchased for us by Jesus. He gives the gift of the Father, the Spirit. These are just some things for you to ponder this week. I hope they're helpful. I hope they continue to be helpful, and I welcome you to just continue to think about them as you go about your weeks. God bless you, and may you find hope and strength and encouragement in Him.